Hi, Anthony Carlo here with Ron Darling. Ron, thank you for being with me. Today we'll see a new face on the Mets, and that is Kevin Plawecki. What is your opinion of him so far?
Well, he's just, he's the real deal. He's just one of those prospects that you can't wait to see him play in the major leagues. A college kid, you hate to see him in the big leagues because of Travis Darnell's misfortune, but... opportunities in the major leagues are very capricious, so you just don't know when they're going to come your way. And I hope he makes the most of it because of all the people I've talked to and in watching him play, he has all the talent in the world.
Now, you spoke about Travis d'Arnaud. It came at his expense. He was leading the team with he had a 317 average and leading with 10 RBIs. But what does it say for this organization to have so a plethora of talent behind the plate?
Well, I think they've done a great job. Sandy Alderson's done a great job of not only behind the plate, but also everywhere in the pitching department. There's some real good everyday players coming up. So that's what you got to have in today's game, unless you're going to spend, like the Dodgers, $250 million. You've got to have the ability that when guys get hurt, that you have good players come to replace them. And the Mets certainly have that with Plawecki.
Speaking out of a pitcher's perspective, how do you feel with a young catcher coming up, stepping into the spotlight? Do you think he'll adapt right away to the pitching staff?
You know, the one thing I've heard about Kevin, and I haven't talked to him about this, but everyone raves about his intelligence. So he'll pick it up quickly. It's not as difficult as people say it is. I think a lot of times it can be made more difficult because of all the numbers you have. But basically, he's catching John Neese tonight. It's going to be a lot of cutters. You try to mix in a curveball and changeup and keep the ball down. They've been doing that for the last 110 years, and it kind of works. So I'm sure that he'll be able to not get any paralysis by analysis. He'll make it simple.
And finally, with the Mets being on an 8-game winning streak, what does that mean based on all the injuries they've had to be this good so early on?
Well, you can't win the division in April, but you certainly can lose it. And I think what they've done is they put themselves in position in a couple of ways. One, they've proven that they can run off some wins. Two, they've proven that they can win at home. And three, they put themselves in a position now where they don't have to panic. They have to win series. So they're playing Atlanta, take two out of three, move on against the Yankees, do the same. That's how good teams operate. And let's hope the Mets are one of those good teams.